a first-of-its-kind device to free kidney patients from dialysis. Let's take a view inside Dr. William Fazell's artificial kidney. Kidney disease patient William Haynes is an optimist.
Glass is always half full.
But even his good spirits can't keep him from endless hours in this kidney dialysis chair.
3 days a week, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, from about noon until 4:30, 5 o'clock. I'm gonna do what I need to do to live.
He and some 450,000 Americans are tied to dialysis machines because their kidneys are failing. Haynes has been on a transplant wait list for years.
But I was like first or second on their list for a while, and it just never happened.
Last year, just 17,000 people nationwide received a life-saving transplant. This Vanderbilt researcher is leading the fight to change those odds.
I have this wacky idea that we can make an implantable artificial kidney, this holy grail that's been talked about.
Powered by a patient's own heart.
We think that we can get a device down small enough that it can get enough clearance, enough removal of waste products, enough removal of salt and water to keep a patient off dialysis, but still be small enough, like Coke can size, coffee can size, to fit inside a patient's body cavity.
The key? This tiny chip.
It's called silicon nanotechnology. It uses the same processes that were developed by the microelectronics industry for computers, for this, for this, for this.
The chips are affordable, precise, and make ideal filters.
And the ability to design each and every pore in the filter one by one based on what you want that pore to do.
They do more than filter.
They're also the scaffold on which the cells will rest.
Living kidney cells grown in this lab are part of the device.
If you think about a kidney, they all have two common structures. They have a filtration part, and they have a gland-like structure of epithelial cells that's called the tubule.
Which reabsorbs water and other elements your body wants to keep.
We can leverage Mother Nature's 60 million years of research and development and use those kidney cells that fortunately for us grow promiscuously in the lab dish and grow them into a bioreactor of living cells that will be the only Santa Claus membrane in the world, the only membrane that knows which solutes have been naughty and which solutes have been nice and are able to reabsorb the stuff your body needs and discard the stuff that your body desperately wants to get rid of.
This biohybrid device sits out of reach from the body's immune response, protecting it from rejection.
The issue is not one of immune compliance, of matching like it is with an organ transplant.
Now putting the artificial kidney to work.
So this is a prototype that we're using in our preclinical testing right now.
The device operates naturally with a patient's blood flow.
Our challenge is to take blood in a blood vessel and transform that pulsating, unsteady flow and distribute it amongst a large number of these little flat chips. We use the same sort of technology that's used to make a modern commercial jet.
Fluid dynamics. And that's where Vanderbilt bioengineer Amanda Buck comes in.
So we're looking at the device to see if there are certain regions that cause recirculation regions or areas that might cause clotting in the device.
Playing with the channel shape.
We rapidly prototype using 3D printing the shapes that we've modeled.
Making blood flow smoothly.
And we circle back and we improve our design again and again and again.
The trial device holds two filters.
The real world device that will scale up for actual clinical use will probably hold 15 or 16 plates in a stack.
Fazell says he has a long list of dialysis patients eager to join the trial.
My patients are absolutely my heroes. They come back again and again and again and suffer a crushing burden of illness because they want to live. And they're willing to put all of that at risk for the sake of another patient.
Haynes is enthusiastic about a brighter future for kidney disease patients like himself.
You've got the disease, there is no cure. but at the same time, is not necessarily a death sentence. So just live. I've got 9 grandchildren, and having 9 grandchildren, I want to be around for them.
Groundbreaking work to help the millions of kidney patients to come.